Today we're going to talk about how to install multiple types of fan voltages, being 24 volt, 12 volt, or 5 volt on the Bigtree Tech Octopus Pro. Now, this also applies to the Bigtree Tech Octopus version 1.1. So I'll walk you through this in a second. Now I'm going to turn this fan over in a second just so that you can see the blades moving. Now keep in mind that I had to use this fan because my other fan was broken. So you'll be able to see this turn, hopefully, if I do this correct. So there's a couple of things we need to learn real quick. Now I've replaced the jumpers over here for the jumper caps to red jumper caps so you can see better. But there's three levels that you can set them to. Right now they're default 24 volt. There's also 12 volt and 5 volt up above. Over here though is the main voltage for the rail. So I'm setting it to 24 volts for the PSU or power supply. But you also have the option for 12 volts and 5 volts for this rail. So you'll be able to actually vary the voltage right here. So to do this, we're going to go to the manual for a second, and we're going to see what it looks like inside of there. So over in the manual, you can see right here that it's fan and proximity switch voltage settings. Down here, they talk about the actual settings. So the 24 volts is right here. Then it's 12 volts, then it's 5 volts. Then they talk about the rail. Over here it's 24 volts, over here it's 12 volts, and then finally you have 5 volts. So if you've seen my tutorials for the automatic fans on the advanced configuration, this is going to be slightly different, but it'll give you an understanding of how you can set variable fans in your configuration. So it's going to be slightly different. So I'm going to be actually using G codes for this. So I'm going to be using the M106 to set the fan speed. And the command is going to be M106P, and then it's going to say which fan. And then the speed of the fan in this case is going to be S, and then the speed. I don't know why they put T here, but okay, we'll figure that out some other time. So, in order to set this up, what we're going to have to do is understand where the fans are. So, I pulled up the actual configuration for the fans for the Octopus Pro, and you can see that there's fan number 0 to 7. But a better way to see this is actually with the original Octopus, where you can zoom in and actually get a clearer picture of this. So as you can see, it's fan 0 all the way to fan 7. But remember, fan 6 and fan 7 are direct power fans. So you can set those with the jumpers above right here. And they give the order of them. They also give the one over here, which I'll talk about in just a second, in the actual workbench. So let's go back over to the table and take a look at this. So, as you can see, we've got the 24 volt set. We're going to be using a 24 volt power supply. So what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to adjust fan 0, 1, and 2 for our different voltages. So this one I'm not going to move, but I'm going to move this one so I can set it to 12 volts. Then I'm going to set the 5 volt fan, right here. And then I'm going to plug each one of these in. So I'm going to start with the 24 volts, which is going to be right here. Then I'm going to do the 12 volt, and this one might be kind of fun to plug in. And then finally the 5 volt, which will be right over here. Now I've tested this with a multimeter, so in theory it should work no problem. So let me weight this down real quick so that these are out of the way so you can see. And I'm going to pop the drive out so I can actually program it. So there's not much programming involved, but I'm just showing you the process, like always, so that we can run through a common way to do this. So I'm going to put this in a USB reader, and I'm going to plug this into the computer. You may hear a beep. Now I'm going to actually plug in the power, and if you haven't noticed before, I like to put the color of voltage on the actual screw so I can avoid plugging this in wrong. Now I'm plugging in the actual power for the actual motors. We're not going to actually be using them, but I just want to do that to keep them out of the way. And I'm going to plug in this one as well. This is the main power, and then the actual ground for it. Now there has been some debate several times during my tutorials where the manual might read something else initially, and then the board says something different. Always go by the board first or check with the manufacturer, because if there's a difference between the manual that we just looked at and the actual board, it's a good thing to understand what those are. So let's go over to the computer for a second. And I'm going to bring up VS Code. I'm going to click on File. Then I'm going to open Folder. I'm going to go to my Downloads folder and open up my Marlin folder, my next Marlin folder, then Select Folder. Inside here, what I need to do is set, obviously, my default environment, because it's the default for the Mega 2560. And I also have to set my motherboard. So I'm going to go to Marlin. Then I'm going to go to Source, Core, Boards.h. I'm going to search on Octopus. And as you can see, we're using the Pro, so I'm going to highlight that and copy it. We're also going to make note of what chipsets we can use. Now, the current chipset I'm using is the STM32F4, which is right here. So it's going to be 446, and the reason we know that is the center chip on the board will be our MCU or CPU, as some people call it, and it'll have this writing on it. That tells us which environment we're using for our chipset. But I'm going to minimize this and source, then go to configuration.h. I'm going to search on motherboard, and I'm going to paste it over the RAMP's configuration. Next, I'm going to change the serial port to -1. And then I'm going to go over to the advanced configuration. And we're not going to be doing what we've done in previous tutorials where I show you the automatic fan. So there's nothing really to change here. So next, what we're going to have to do is set up the platform io.ini. So we're going to minimize the Marlin folder for a moment, go over to the INI folder, and we're going to find our chipset, which is the STM32F4. Inside here, we're going to search on Octopus, and as you can see, our chipset is either for the regular Octopus or the Pro, and our environment's going to be this. And the reason we know this is based on the STM32F446. So let's go back over here and paste the default environment in here. And then we're going to click clean, because there was a previous build that was in here for the Mega 2560. And then we're going to build it with the checkbox. Now keep in mind, if it fails on the very first build, try the checkbox down here a second time, because sometimes things build out of order. If you do see a red marking of some type in here, it usually says you have a compiler failure, so you'll have to correct the very first one you see, because the other ones might be a cascade of errors based on that. So once this completes, what we'll do is we'll go over to the .pio folder for the BigTree Tech Octopus version 1. And we'll find our firmware.bin. We'll right click and say reveal in file explorer. Now, if you haven't noticed before, there's a firmware.cur. This is the actual build that completed and installed based on this one. So we're going to send this to our D drive. And just so you know, if you ever want to reload firmware.cur, you can rename it to firmware.bin. and use that also for multiple configurations of the same type. So I'm going to pop out the drive in a second and bring it over to the configuration. I'm going to place the drive inside for the SD card, and I'm going to plug it into load. This may take a few seconds. You'll see a flashing light in this section. Once that's completed, which it already has because you hear the ding on the computer, you can unplug it. And normally when you run it off the power supply, you're going to remove this jumper and place it right here, plug this in, and the board won't have power at the moment. So we're going to plug it in, and this will power the board. Once the board is powered up, we'll go over to Pronterface, and we'll actually configure it. So inside Pronterface, you can see that it's on COM port 1 because I had it open before the load. And sometimes you'll actually see the COM port if you've already worked with it. But if you have not, what you can do is this. You can go over to your regular desktop and you can type device manager. And once device manager comes up, you can go to your COM ports and verify that it's connected. So I'm going to change this to 15 and then I'm going to connect. And now that we have that set up, what we're going to do is test the fans. So in order to do that, we'll use the G code M106. Then we'll say which fan it is by saying P0, that's the 24 volt fan. And then the speed we'll say is 200, and we'll press enter. So watch the fan. So as you can see, it's now running. Now if we want to test this for the other fans, we can change the P0 to a P1 and then press enter. That'll be the next fan over. And that one is now running. Now let's try the 5 volt one, which is going to be P2, and press enter. So as you can see, all the fans are running. So now we can actually turn off fans by saying M107 P0, and then we can hit enter, and hopefully this will turn off the fan. Otherwise, we have another command we can try. So it looks like it turned off the first fan. Now let's try the second fan over here. So it's going to be P1, and we'll press enter. And let's try the final fan, which is P2. So I want to take a moment to thank my patrons for helping make this video possible. I'll put a link in the description if you're not a patron yet, so that can help offset the costs to make these tutorials and part of my time. And everyone else, be safe, get vaccinated, wear a mask, and thank you very much.